is coming. We are going, so we are changing. Holy Spirit of the Most High God, the Spirit of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, you have authorized me to preach the good news. I am so confident, oh Lord, that you use me again as your microphone to speak your word to your world. Thank you, Father, for salvation of souls. Thank you, Father, for healing. Thank you for all the things you're about to do now. You are going to do wonders without number. Daddy, is not about the religions. It's not about the nationalities. It's not about the culture. It's about the soon coming Jesus. Receive all the glory, Lord. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. That we give you all the praises. We give you all the glory. We honor you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for you are here. You are here. You are here to speak to your people again. Thank you, Father, for you will pass through me. I am nothing without the Holy Spirit of the Most High God. Thank you, Ancient of Days. You are coming back. That's the good news. Thank you, Father. Jesus Christ is coming back. He is coming back. Welcome to the moment of good news. Beloved, Jesus Christ is coming back. He is coming back. I know you are excited that Jesus is coming back. Jesus is coming back. Thank you, Father. He's coming back again. He's coming back again. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. You're coming back. We are so excited. We are so glad that you're coming back. Thank you, Father. Jesus Christ is coming back. And very, very soon. Oh, look at the scripture. Look at John chapter 14. Oh, from verse 1 to 3. The Bible says, Jesus Christ himself says to us, thank you, Father. Remember, he's the same yesterday, the same today, the same forever, the same way he spoke in the past. That's how he's speaking to you now. Thank you, Father. John 14 from verse 1 to 3. The Bible says, Jesus Christ says, do not let your heart be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms, are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going there to prepare a place for you. Wow. Verse 3 says, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back. He says, I will come back. Jesus says he will come back. Praise God. He doesn't lie. He says, I will come back. Oh, thank you, Father. To do what? And take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. He's coming back. And we're excited because he's coming back for us. Thank you, Father. The Bible says, he says, oh, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. A very glorious place. He's coming back to take us to that place. And I know that none of you, none of us will miss that in the name of the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. It's a moment of good news. Good news from glory to glory. Good news. Oh, I'm so excited that Jesus is coming back. He's coming back. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Today we shall be looking at the rapture, the first stage of the second coming. You know, we have the rapture and also the second coming. The rapture, he will come and he will stay in the air, and all of us will meet him there. The believers, the true believers, the Christians will meet him in the air from there to heaven. It's only the Christians, only the believers that will see him. But the second coming, all of us, the raptured saints, will come back with him. I'm going to talk about that one today, and that day we'll talk about that. But today I want to pay more attention to the first stage, that's the rapture. And it's coming back very, very soon. This message is for the believers to encourage you. Oh, you have to be excited that Jesus is coming. I say he's coming. You got to be excited that he's coming back. He is coming back for you, and no one will stop him. He has said it, and he will do it. He does not lie. Thank you, Father. Well, like I told us last time, the rapture is an event that will take place in the next future. is an event that will take place in the nearest future. Jesus Christ will come. He will stay in the air, and the trumpet shall sound. The dead in Christ shall rise first. The Christians are alive. All of us will fly and we'll meet him in the air, from there to heaven. And all of us will be with him forever and ever. And that will be your portion. That will be your testimony. We shall testify. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 1. Oh, look at the scripture. Now, let me remind you, dear brothers and sisters, of the good news. You remember the moment of good news? Of the good news I preached to you before. You welcomed it then and still do now, for your faith is built on this wonderful message. Wow. Look at the message you had. What has given us the hope that we are rapturable, that we are flying? Look at that message. The message we have received. The Bible says that faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. We keep hearing this word. We keep hearing this. The message you have heard, oh, that he has given us the hope that we are rapturable. Thank you, Father. Bless the name, Lord. Oh, thank you, Father. Verse 2 says, and it is this good news that saves you if you firmly believe it. Unless, of course, you believe something that was never true in the first place. The message I pass on to you, praise God. What, oh, thank you, Father, on to you. What was most important and what had also been passed on to me, praise God, that Christ died for our sins, just as the scriptures said. The good news. And that's what qualifies you. You believe that Jesus died for your sins. And he's seated at the right of the Father. And is coming back for you. Oh, the Bible says that you are saved. Thank you, Father. God is so good. The simple gospel, so simple, so fascinating, so interesting. I am so excited that Jesus died for me. Jesus died for me. Thank you, Father. Adam brought sin. I was not there. And because of what Adam did, I became a sinner. But because of what Jesus Christ did, I have become God's righteousness in Christ Jesus. Shout hallelujah. If you are excited, shout hallelujah. If you had believed that Adam brought sin, you can also believe that Jesus Christ brought righteousness, and you will be saved. That's the good news. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Look at another exciting one. Exciting word. So fascinating. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, from verse 13 to 18. Follow me to that place. Oh, I'll wait for you. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4. Oh, thank you, Father. Go to the scripture and see what God is saying. The good news you need to get. We will grab this good news as we rejoice. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name, Lord. Jesus Christ is coming back. And we are going. And we are changing. Amen. And we are changing. Amen. I say you are changing. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, I'll be reading from verse 13. Thank you, Father. Verse 13 to 18. Brothers, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep, or to grieve like the rest of men who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again. That is the message, the good news. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will bring with him, or with Jesus, those who have fallen asleep. That's the good news. Oh, the same thing they saw in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, from verse 1 to 3. We believe that Jesus died and rose again. Thank you, Ancient of Days, La Crabrose Jindala. I give you praises, mighty God. Verse 15 says, according to the Lord's own word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left till the coming of the Lord, we certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. That's the good news. All those that died in Christ, those are relatives. Oh, like my mother that died in Christ, we'll meet her again. All those that died in Christ, who have the hope, who will see them again. Praise God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. This is the good news. I am so excited. I am so excited. Verse 16 says, for the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with a trumpet call of God. And the dead in Christ will rise first. The dead in Christ, all those ladies that died in Christ, the Bible says that they will rise first. That's the good news. I know you're excited. The dead in Christ will rise first. Verse 17 says, and that, after that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Shout hallelujah. We'll meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. We will be with the Lord forever. The one that loves us so passionately, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Ancient of Days, the one that created heavens and earth. The Bible says that we will be with him forever. You can't afford to miss rapture. The moment rapture takes place, all of us will be with him forever. He cannot leave us. We will be with Christ forever. We will be with Christ forever. In verse 18, it says, therefore, encourage each other with these words. Encourage your friends. Encourage your relatives. Encourage your brothers and sisters that Jesus Christ is coming again. And as he comes, all of us will be with him forever. Oh, none of us will miss it. None of us will miss it. All my friends, all my childhood friends, all my relatives, all the church members, all the Christians, all the Saving Act members, my neighbors in heaven, all of us will be with Christ forever. We will be with Christ forever. Thank you, Father. There shall be no death, no more death, no more sickness, no more coronavirus to fear, nothing at all. All of us will be with him forever. That is the portion in the name of Jesus. As you share this message, as your brothers and sisters hear this, and they will be saved. Believe me, you'll be so happy, you'll be so glad that day you will remember that this message you shared has really saved a soul, and you will get your reward in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name we are prayed. He's coming back again. He's coming back again. Thank you, Jesus. He's coming back again. Glory, hallelujah. Praise his holy name. Praise God. He's coming back again. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, you and I worship God in heaven forever and ever. You can't afford to miss it in the name of Jesus. There won't be dull moment in heaven. It will be so exciting. Our God is so exciting. Heaven will be so exciting. No dull moment. No dull moment. Music everywhere. Food everywhere. All the things you need. You have them in abundance everywhere. Oh, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Now, is it true that he's coming back soon? Soon? Is it true that he's coming back soon? Let's see the scripture and let's confirm what the Bible says. Israel is a sign that Jesus Christ is coming back very, very soon. Israel is a sign that Jesus is coming back very soon. How do I know that? Now look at Isaiah chapter 60 and verse 8. Isaiah 60 and verse 8 says, oh, thank you, Father, Lekara Bro Shundra. Isaiah 60 and verse 8 says, who are these that fly along like clouds, like doves to their nest? Isaiah saw this. Verse 9. Surely the island looks to me in the lead are the ships of Tarshish, bringing their sons from afar with their silver and gold to the honor of the Lord their God, the Holy One of Israel. Isaiah saw something so great. Beloved, when Isaiah saw this, when Isaiah had this revelation, when God showed Isaiah this, there was nothing like aeroplane. Nothing like aeroplane. But what did Isaiah see? What did he see? He saw aeroplanes. Beloved, if aeroplane is far and you are here watching aeroplane, it will be as if you are seeing or you are watching doves, bears. So the only way Isaiah could explain that, so he said, they look like doves to their nest, doves, like glass. There were so many, like doves to their nest, to their house. Praise God. What Isaiah saw was aeroplanes. Aeroplanes. Praise God. Now, the Tarshish there represents the Western nations, Western world. That's Great Britain and United States of America. The ship of Tarshish. They represent United States of America and Great Britain. Praise God. So he says, who are these that fly along like clouds, like doves to their nest? Surely the island looks to me. In the lead are the ships of Tarshish, the ships from the Great Britain, or the ships that belong to Great Britain, or aeroplanes of Great Britain and the United States of America, bringing your sons from afar with their silver and gold to the honor of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel. Praise God. Now, let me explain something to you. I know someone is confused here. Thank you, Father. Now, in 14th May 1948, this prophecy was fulfilled. 14th May 1948, this prophecy was fulfilled. What Isaiah saw came to pass. After the Second World War, in 1947-1948, United States of America and Great Britain played the major roles. Praise God. They formed the United Nations. What did they do? They sent aeroplanes to different parts of the world to gather all the Israelites, to gather them. Remember, they were scattered. They were in captives. The time of Nebuchadnezzar, Daniel was there. Abednego, Shadrach, and Meshach, they were there. Esther was also there. Mordecai was there. So most of the Israelites scattered because of what they did, because they offended God. God, in his own message, prophesied or spoke through his prophet Isaiah that time is coming when these people will come back to Israel. That thing God showed Isaiah was fulfilled in 1948. God used the United Nations to gather the Israelites. They came back to Israel. Praise God. In 1948, you see, they sent different aeroplanes to different places. Isaiah saw, who are these that fly along like clouds? Aeroplanes, some of them like clouds. They were flying, they were moving down to Israel like doves to their nest. Praise God. God's word cannot be changed. God cannot change. His word is here and amen. Praise God. Israel is a sign of rapture, a sign of his coming. I will show you something. Just stay tuned. You will understand what God wants you to understand now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Oh, why is Israel a sign? Look at another one. Oh, Israel is that fig tree. Hosea chapter 9 and verse 10. God says, I found Israel, your fathers, as the first fruits of the fig tree. That's what God said through his prophet Hosea in chapter 9 and verse 10. I found Israel, your fathers, as the first fruits. Oh, thank you, Jesus. The first fruits on the fig tree. Fig tree. So Israel is the fig tree. Thank you, Jesus. Israel is the fig tree. Now, in Matthew 24, from verse 32, Jesus Christ himself made mention of that, referring Israel as the fig tree. Oh, praise God. Referring Israel as the fig tree. Look at the scripture now. Now, learn this lesson. That's Matthew 24 from verse 32. Now, learn this lesson from the fig tree. That's from Israel. Learn this lesson from Israel, from the fig tree. As soon as its twigs get tender and its leaves come out, you know that summer is near. You know that the time is near. Even so, when you see all these things, you know that it is near, right at the door. Verse 34 says, I tell you the truth. This generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away. Praise God. Thank you, Father. In furtherance, in verse 36, it says, no one knows about that time, that day, the hour, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. As it was in the time of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of God, Son of Man. Now, Israel as a fig tree, as a sign of the rapture. Like I told you, Israel is a fig tree in accordance with Hosea 9, verse 10. And Jesus Christ himself says, now learn this lesson from the fig tree. As soon as its twigs get tender and its leaves come out, What does that mean? Like I told you, what Isaiah saw in Isaiah chapter 60 and verse 8, that Israel will come back as a country again. Though they were scattered, they were coming back. That in 1948, United Nations was used by God to bring Israel back to this city where they are, the country where they are now. So the Bible is saying, Jesus is saying in Matthew 24, that the generation that witnesses this, the generation that witnesses this, will surely witness rapture. Yes. The Bible says, the generation that witnessed this, we witness rapture. Look at that again in verse 24, Matthew 24, verse 34. It says, I tell you the truth, and Jesus is the truth. This generation will certainly not pass away until all these things have happened. Which generation? The generation that witnessed the rebirth of Israel. And this thing happened in 1948. So Israel is a sign of rapture. The rapture can take place at any time. Thank you, Father. Like I told you, this is the generation that witnessed the rebirth, that witnessed the rebirth of Israel. The generation that witnessed the rebirth of Israel. This generation we are seeing now. And for the Father, this generation witnessed it. This generation will witness rapture. Thank you, Father. As a matter of fact, we are the third end. At the third end, this generation, it will not pass until rapture takes place. And you will not miss rapture in the name of the Lord Jesus. I say you will not miss rapture in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Why Israel? Remember the covenant God had with Israel. The covenant God had with Abraham, had with Isaac and Jacob. Starting from Abraham in Genesis chapter 17. God is a covenant keeper. He does not change. He had a covenant with Abraham. And Israel is a seed of Abraham. And that covenant is still working. That's why Israel is so important. Praise God. Israel is a sign of rapture. And for the fact that Israel is a sign of rapture, and you are hearing all these, you will not miss rapture in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Ancient of Days. And that sign that he is coming back very, very soon. And that sign, look at this. In Matthew 24 and verse 14, the Bible says, and this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations. That this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations. And then the end will come. That's what Jesus says, that this gospel will be preached all around the world. All the ethnic groups will hear that Jesus Christ is Lord, that he came, that he died, oh, he was buried, and he rose from the dead. He is seated, and he's coming back. Praise God, that this gospel will go around, not for all to believe, but for all to know that Jesus Christ came, he died as an escape route. Praise God. Now, why is that a sign? The gospel, the way the gospel is spreading, confirms, shows that rapture can take place at any time. If Jesus Christ could give that as a condition, that the gospel would go around the world, then the end will come. Believe me, anything can happen at any time. Just imagine the internet, how people are using the internet to preach the gospel all around the world. Even the countries that said no to Jesus, they are listening to the gospel. They are hearing the good news that Jesus Christ is Lord, that Jesus Christ came, he died, and he's coming back. Oh, thank you, Ancient of Days. Thank you, Father. That's another sign that Jesus Christ is coming back, and very, very soon. And for the fact that you are listening to me, the power of God is upon you right now. You cannot miss rapture. None of your family members will miss rapture in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Oh, we are excited. Christians are excited. We are happy that Jesus Christ is coming. Why are we excited? Why are we happy? Why are we rejoicing? We are not like the unbelievers that are crying, that are mourning, that are weeping. They are always afraid. They are perturbed. They are disturbed. The moment you mention our church, they will be angry. They will be afraid. We are not like that. That's why it's a good news. Christians are happy that Jesus is coming. Christians are happy that rapture will take place. We are happy. Why are we happy? Look at this. We are happy because God does not want us to be part of the tribulation. The church is happy. Christians are happy. They are not angry. They are happy because God has a plan for us. He doesn't want us to be part of the tribulation. Tribulation is coming immediately after rapture. There will be 7 years here on earth. People will suffer. Coronavirus is nothing. People will suffer. And you will not be here in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Look at the scripture, Revelation 13 and verse 16. The Bible says that he also forced everyone, small and great, rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark on his right hand or on his forehead. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So that no one could buy or sell unless he had a mark. Thank you, Jesus. Which is the name of the beast or the number of his name? Verse 18 says, this calls for wisdom. If anyone has insight, let him calculate the number of the beast. For it is man's number. His number is 666. Immediately after rapture, the Antichrist will take over. Terrible things will begin to happen on earth. Things that are worse than coronavirus. Coronavirus is nothing compared to the things that will happen after rapture. And Jesus does not want us to be part of it. That's why he will snatch us out of this world. That's why rapture will take place. That's why he will take us out of this world. So that we will not be part of this suffering. And for the fact that you are here listening to me, you will not be part of this in the name of the Lord Jesus. You will not be here. You will not face the Antichrist in the name of Jesus. Your family members will not meet the Antichrist. You will have been raptured in the name of the Lord Jesus. I say you'll be raptured in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We are excited because we'll be raptured. We will not be part of this nonsense the Antichrist is planning to do. He will give people mark. He will control the whole world. As a matter of fact, all the things they want to use, they are preparing all of them now. All the gadgets, all the instruments, all the technologies they want to use after rapture, all of them are in place. The moment rapture takes place, they will flood everything. And you will not be here in the name of the Lord Jesus. So the church is rejoicing, or we are rejoicing because we will not be part of the Antichrist agenda. I say you will not be part of this agenda. You can't be part of this. In the name of the Lord Jesus, thank you, Father. Oh, why are we excited? See, number two, we are excited because God, Jesus Christ, is coming back to reward us. The Bible says in Revelation 22, verse 12, he says, behold, I come quickly, and my rewards are with me. I will reward you according to the works you are doing. We are rejoicing because he's coming back. It's a good news. He's coming back to reward you. That's why in your church, I encourage you to be so committed, be committed. Serve the Lord in spirit and in truth. If you don't have a church, look for a church, a Bible-believing church closer to you. Join them, walk with the vision. Every message has salvation in it. If it's healing that your church is running, no problem. There's salvation in healing. There's salvation in every message. Join the church. Walk with your pastor. The Bible says that Jesus is coming to reward us according to the works. Why works? Praise God. Why works? The church work. Why the church work? The church is God's organization, God's family. The church is God's own family on earth. His own family, his own assignment on earth is the church right now. Right now. I know you are surprised. In Matthew chapter 16 and verse 18, Jesus Christ says, I will build my church and the gates of hell will not prevail. He says, I will build my church I will build my church, and I expect it to be part of the church. I expect it to walk with me. Walk. I will build my church. That's what he said before he died. Praise God. Thank you, Father. Now, in Acts chapter 1, from verse 6 to 8, let's see what the scripture says about his church. Look at the scripture here. In Acts 1, verse 6 to 8, so when they met together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know the times or days the Father has set by his own. You see, the disciples were so intelligent. They knew about the prophecy, what Daniel told them in Daniel chapter 9, about Israel. You know, if Israel has 490 years, so remaining 7 years. So they thought that Jesus Christ will handle that to restore Israel, so that Israel will enter the spiritual state. But he told them something. They didn't know that he had a plan, that the plan at that moment was to establish his church. That 7 years will surely come. That's what that 7 years I was talking about after rapture. And that day I will talk about all this, the 7 years tribulation, and you will understand how these 7 years came about. So he told them, go and do church work first. After the church, the 7 years will take place, it will come to pass. Praise God, and I will restore Israel to the spiritual state. Praise God. Thank you, Father. Now, this is the era of the church. Look at what he told us in Acts chapter 1, from verse 6 to 8. So when they met together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom to Israel? He said to them, it is not for you to know the times or days the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power. Verse 8. You will receive power to do what? To do the church work. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. Oh, mighty God, I give you praises. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria, the ends of the earth. You will take the church walk around the world. That is my assignment, the church walk. When the church walk, planting churches at different places so that the gospel be spread. If you're not spreading the gospel, if you're not telling people about Jesus Christ, it means that, thank you, Father, give you praises, Lord. Thank you, Father, for the church. Oh, for the Father, the church is here. But we stop the church. The gates of hell will not stop the church. Oh, Maraka Zendalabro Shundra, Li Kabraho Shundra Lakande Kabra. That's why the church is here. We are here. Thank you, Father. Oh, and that is why we're excited. And that is why it's a good news. We're excited. Oh, the third reason here, Jesus is coming to establish an everlasting covenant called the marriage supper of the Lamb. And that reason why we are excited. Jesus Christ is coming to establish, oh, that covenant. You remember, you are betrothed. You have been engaged. The bride. And he is the groom. For the Father, they have accepted him as Lord and Savior. He is coming back. And after rapture, one of the major events is the marriage supper of the Lamb. And you and I will be there in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. If you're happy, why not shout amen? Thank you, Father. Revelation 19 from verse 6 to 9 says, then I heard what sounded like a great multitude, like the roar of rushing waters, and like loud peals of thunder, shouting, hallelujah. Say hallelujah. 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 For our Lord God Almighty reigns. Oh, let us rejoice and be glad and give him glory. For the wedding of the Lamb has come. Oh, thank you, Jesus. The wedding of the Lamb has come. And his bride has made herself ready. Fine linen, bright and clean, was given her to wear. Oh, Raka Jendela Rabro Shindela. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Fine linen stands for the righteous ass of the saints. Jesus Christ has made you righteous, and you remain righteous forever. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, verse 9 says, right, blessed are those who are invited to the wedding supper of the Lamb. You are invited. You can't afford to miss it. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, you can't afford to miss it. Don't you want to be part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be part of the kingdom? Come on, everybody. There is peace in the kingdom. So much fun in the kingdom. So much peace in the kingdom. Come on. Come on, everybody. We are the bride. Why Jesus Christ is the groom. You can't afford to miss it. Thank you, Father. Next time we shall continue. I will tell you all you need to know about the second coming, the Armageddon War, the defeat of the Antichrist, how Satan will be chained for 1,000 years, the millennium reign for 1,000 years. You and I will reign in Jerusalem. Praise God. Oh, thank you, Father. I will tell you why they are fighting Israel. Why people are fighting Israel, even those that are supporting Israel, are fighting them. Praise God. I will tell you the reason why they are fighting them. I will talk about the final battle as Satan will be released again after 1,000 years. Oh, thank you, Father. Then the end of Satan. I will tell you about the end of Satan, how Satan will end his journey, how his journey will be ended. Thank you, Father. We'll talk about the white throne judgment, the new heaven. Oh, we'll talk about the new heaven and the new earth. We'll talk about the lake of fire. And that is not your portion, because the moment you make rapture, the moment you are raptured, you begin to enjoy from glory to glory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And talk about the new heaven and the new earth. Don't miss rapture. Don't miss rapture. That's the main thing, like I told you. The moment you are raptured, you won't be part of the nonsense. You'll be part of the glorious things that will happen. And the saints will rejoice forever and ever in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. 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 You and I will sing this song in heaven by the power in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We will sing this song. We will sing this song. I say we will sing this song. You will not miss rapture. We will sing this song. We will surround Jesus and we sing this song unto him. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name, Lord. In Jesus' name we are praying. Thank you, Father. I know someone wants to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. If you want to accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, I want to pray with you right now. And Jesus Christ will come into your life. He will become your Lord and your Savior. Oh, you'll be rapturable in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Are you ready to pray this prayer with me? Before I pray for you. Marako Shandalala. Say, Lord Jesus. Now repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I believe the word. I believe the scriptures. The word I have here. I believe all. That you are the Lord, the Son of God. You came, you died for me. You rose from the dead. You are seated in heaven. And you are coming back for me. I believe with all my heart, you are the Lord. Today I declare as I have believed, you are my Lord and you are my Savior. Thank you for accepting me. Thank you, Father, for forgiving all my sins. Blessed be the name, Lord. In Jesus' name I have prayed. If you have prayed a prayer, congratulations, the Lord has accepted you. He has written your name in the book of life and you are rapturable. No power will stop you. No man will stop you in the name of Jesus Christ. I bless you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says, oh, in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, then other things will be added unto you. For the fact that you have accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, for the fact that you are excited about the kingdom, about the rapture, I release blessings unto you. All the blessings you need before the rapture, spiritual blessings, financial blessings, receive them now. Receive divine health. Receive divine health. Peace is coming now to your marriage. Peace is coming to your womb. You are fruitful. I say you are fruitful. You are fruitful in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, that I give you all the praises for all that you have done. Receive all the praises, Lord. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Oh, thank you for all that you have done, Jesus. You have done it again. Holy Ghost, I give you praises. You have passed through me, Lord. Oh, thank you, Father. Receive all the praises, Lord. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Congratulations. Something good has happened. I encourage you to share this message so that your friends, relatives will hear, will see the message. And God will deliver them. God will save their souls in the name of Jesus. And there will not be eternal separation. You will be in heaven. Your friends will be in heaven. All of us will be in heaven and will rejoice. Oh, thank you, Father. Blessed be the name, Lord. In Jesus' wonderful name we are prayed. Amen.